Welcome to our online service this Sunday as we meet Claire Bedford of BMS World Mission in Chad. We see her only last summer telling us all about Guinea-Bar 2 Hospital. The theme for today is God's blessing through the rain. So we will include a link earlier for any youngsters that want to hear the story of Noah from my friend Trevor Rowe. Just click and download it if appropriate. Meanwhile, we're in week eight, and we in the UK have seen some changes. We've watched the joy on the faces of people from other parts of the world where restrictions have been eased or even largely lifted. You can tell that things are moving in our country as the unity that we all experienced in the beginning is starting to crack. Some are becoming frustrated, some are cautious, some are skeptical, but there's still a joy every time we read a report or see someone leaving the ICU department and the ritual of the staff clapping them. We pray that we will realize that through all of our experiences, unity is not the same as uniformity. We're called to exhibit the spirit of unity, and that will show us as Christians as distinctive. So let's join together and sing in worship the Servant King.
To
Lord, we come to you in prayer, and we thank you for the recovery of Non home from hospital after suffering from COVID-19. We praise you that he's able to enjoy the company of his family. Lord, we pray for Luina, the little 5-year-old whose grandfather is a friend, as she lies in the hospital bed in Bristol. Lord, we pray that she continues her recovery from such horrendous injuries suffered in Cornwall. And Lord, we pray for the specialist team flown in from Cardiff. We thank you for the improvements in the little one's condition, and we praise that you are indeed doing a mighty work in her life. Lord, we admit that it's been a challenging week with several of our fellowship and friends suffering from poor health in hospital, in terms of getting treatment, in terms of receiving operations. Lord, we bring them all before you. In your healing power, Lord, hear our prayers. And as we think about what we've been praying, we listen to a song that Nicholas shared with us earlier this week called Blessings.
We pray for blessings, we pray for peace, comfort for family, protection while we sleep. We pray for healing, for prosperity. We pray for your mighty hand to ease our suffering. And all the while you hear each spoken need, yet love is way too much to give us lesser things. 'Cause what if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? What if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? What if trials of this life are your mercies in disguise? Pray for wisdom, your voice to hear. And we cry in anger when we cannot feel you near. We doubt your goodness, we doubt your love, as if every promise from your word is not. When friends betray us. life, the rain, the storms, the hardest nights, all your mercies in disguise.
And what of the trials of this life? We turn to have a reading from 2 Chronicles, chapter 7, and just two verses, 13 and 14. When I shut up the heavens so that there is no rain, or command locusts to devour the land, or send a plague among my people, if my people, who are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray, and seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven, and I will forgive their sin, and will heal their land. And so, thanks for that beautiful song that speaks of blessings coming through raindrops, recognizing God's mercies in whatever our situation is. And now we invite Claire Bedford of BMS World Mission, who is in Chad right at this moment and experiencing the coronavirus in a different context, to come and share with us something of what the Lord's doing through the work of the hospital there and how we might pray for the situation. Thanks, Claire.
Hi there, everybody at Desford and Mark at Bosworth, and I know there are other people watching this as well in the area. So greetings from Guinea Board to Hospital in Chad. Thank you for the opportunity to just update you briefly on the situation regarding COVID-19 here in the country. I understand that some of you have watched my previous update video that was recorded a month ago now, in the middle of April, and the situation has unsurprisingly changed a lot here in Chad in the last month. So I just wanted to give you a bit of an update on that. When I last recorded a month ago, there were very few cases in the country. Unfortunately, that is no longer the case. Numbers in the last couple of weeks have really skyrocketed. And we have now, unfortunately, in the country had quite a few deaths reported. The percentage of deaths compared to the numbers of confirmed cases is actually pretty high, which is worrying. The number of confirmed cases are low compared to like the UK. We've got about 400 confirmed cases, and I think it's something like 42 deaths as of now. So that percentage is quite high. Yeah, the numbers are quite low in terms of actual physical confirmed cases, but the amount of tests here are restricted. Like, there's not that many testing facilities, so it's not possible to test absolutely everybody. So hence the confirmed numbers of cases are low. In reality, there's far, far more than 400 cases. It is now pretty prevalent, I would say, in the capital, and it has spread a little bit outside of the capital as well. It's in a total of nine provinces now in Chad. There's at least one case in nine provinces around the country. As a result of these increasing numbers of cases, as I said earlier, they've increased pretty rapidly over the last couple of weeks. We've had lots of cases announced every day. So the government has put in some more measures in place to try and restrict the spread of coronavirus. So it's now obligatory to wear a mask when you're outside, and the police can fine you or even put you in prison if you are found not wearing one. And the other thing they've put in place is to put N'Djamena, the capital, which is where the hospital is based, Guinea Bortu Hospital is based, they've put N'Djamena on quarantine. So that's a week ago now. So no one is allowed to leave the city limits or enter the city limit. Any of us who are already in the city, we can move around within the city. So people can go and buy food or whatever, but no one can travel in or out of the city. So that's the try and obviously stop the spread around the rest of the country. Insofar as what we're doing here at Guinea Board 2 Hospital, we are still not an official treatment centre. That is still the government hospital down the road that I mentioned in my last update. And despite having temperature checking on the gates, we have had a few, not lots, but a few suspect cases managing to enter the hospital. Basically, they came in with no symptoms and they came in with other illnesses. One, for example, came in with uncontrolled diabetes, and then a few days after being in hospital started developing corona symptoms. So we've had a few cases like that, and we are working, when we discover those, we are working with the government hospital to get people followed up and treated at the official treatment centre. In case things skyrocket a little bit more in terms of the numbers of cases we have here at Guinea Board coming through the doors, suspect cases, we do now have a separate area of the hospital, which is our isolation area. There are currently, as I speak, no people in that area, so we don't currently have any suspect cases, so that's a good thing. We're not meant to be housing suspect cases, so hopefully they are all at the government hospital. But yeah, we have got that in place should the need arise. We've also got lots more cleaning products and bits of equipment. The hospital has never been so clean. We've had two visits from the World Health Organization reps in the last few weeks who have been advising us on how to improve our cleaning procedures so that we are disinfecting better than we were before. The hospital was clean before, but there are specific procedures to implement to try and stop the spread of coronavirus. So we've been able to put those things in place, and a lot of that equipment was bought with the BMS grant money that we've received from the coronavirus appeal. So thank you if you've contributed to that appeal. So that's where we're at right now, which is the middle of May. It kind of feels like we're on the upward trend in terms of the numbers of cases. It doesn't feel like we've reached the peak yet. So yeah, we'd appreciate your prayers for the country of Chad. The health system here is pretty flimsy, not very strong. There aren't that many ventilators in country. I've read that there's a total of 20 functioning ventilators for a country of 15 million people. That's not great. So pray for us at Guinea Board that we'll be able to keep coronavirus at bay, and pray for the government of Chad as they try and manage this within the health structures that they have in place. All right, thanks very much. I really appreciate your support and prayers. Bye for now.
Obviously, in the live broadcast, we were able to include prayers for Claire, some things that she spoke about there, and also she was able to answer questions as people asked them live. For now, we are going to conclude our time of worship by singing Thine Be the Glory. If you'd like to ask questions or look at what the prayers might be, then do look at the comment section below. And so if you'd like to get in touch with us so as you can join us for a time of worship at 10:30 on a Sunday morning, do get in touch through Facebook or by our email address. And meanwhile, let's sing together, Thine Be the Glory.